Now that we have designed our house and somewhat also have designed our interior, let's add the lights and calculate the lux level in this project. So for this, what I'm going to do is I am going to go into the light tab here, that is just beside the construction tab, and from here I will be doing anything that is related to light. But first and foremost, the thing is that I need to select the lighting files, or that is also called IES files of the lights, that has all the data of the light. So what I am going to do is I am going to open this manufacturer tab, and from here you can see that at the bottom there are all the brands that are known to us. From here we can select our lights according to our specifications, and those specifications have already been discussed in the lighting design videos. If you haven't seen this, you can follow, open the playlist and see the lighting designs part 1 and part 2 that discusses the concepts of the lighting design. I have opened this catalog or these manufacturers catalog to give you a rough idea that from where and how we can select lights, and Philips is the most used and common brand. So if you want, you can select the light of Philips, but I have here selected the lights of Arco, and I have downloaded 3 lights, and I'll be sharing the link of these 3 lights. If you can't manage to select the lights on your own, you can use them. So after selecting or downloading the lights, these lights will be in my light sections, but from here I can select these lights. So say for example I am selecting this suspended light, and I am going to place it over the dining table, and I am here selecting this place a single luminaire option, and I'm going to here place this light. After this, I'm going to use the surface mounted light. Now I have selected the surface mounted light, and then there are these options of luminaires arrangement. So let me show you this thing, that if I select this arrangement, then I am able to make a rectangular arrangement of the lights. So let me demonstrate. So here I have made a rectangular arrangement, and you can see the grid here. The grid arrangement, I can change this grid arrangement. I can change the number of bulbs in X and Y, and here I can push these bulbs farther apart, or can bring them to only the corners. And by selecting these arrangements, I can change the arrangements of the bulbs in the grid. And through these X and Y, I can also change the number of light bulbs or luminaires in the grid arrangement. So say for example I am changing this to 2, so you can see that these bulbs have only moved to the corners. That is, there will be 3 in the X pair, and there will be 3 in the rows and 2 in the columns, 2 bulbs per column or 3 bulbs per row. So let's have a look in the isometric view. So this is like this, but the suspended light should have had some suspension height. So I'm going to select this light and bring it down. Further select the front view and just select this light, and you can manually enter the height, suspension height. Say for example I am entering here the 3 feet, or also you could have used the cursor keys to move these lights. So I have given 2.5 feet suspension height for this, because 3 feet I think was a little bit too much. So all these terms have been discussed, what is suspension height and stuff. So you can watch the videos if you haven't. Then I'm placing a single luminaire. Now I'm making a line arrangement in front of the kitchen. And also in this line, I can change the arrangement for the bulbs, that where I want these to be in the line and number of bulbs in this line arrangement. So say for example, I'm making this two, so there will be only two lights in here. If I'd make it three, there will be three lights. Now I'm going to add another light here. So I'm using the single light placement option, and in front view it looks like this, and in ISO view it is looking like this. In bedrooms I'm going to use circular arrangement. And this is only because we have already used the other arrangement, so this is just to demonstrate maximum that I can. So this is the circular arrangement, and let's make another circular arrangement here, or give another circular arrangement here. And I can change the number of bulbs in here. I am making it four, and this one also. Now let's place the luminaires in the washrooms, and obviously I'm going to use a single bulb in this one. This can be just in front or in the middle. In the middle would be better, so I'm placing it in the middle. And then the other washroom, I think there should be two bulbs, as this is not of enough wattage. And if I'm going to have a shower area, this shower area might have a curtain in it, so it might get dark. So one bulb here and another here. And for the laundry area, I'm going to use the directional light, that is, I have selected here a floodlight. And so I'll be using this one. And I'm going to use this single luminaire placement. And this would look like this. And as this is a directional light, there is going to be an option for selecting the direction of this light. So this is placed here. Let me adjust the position of this light. So now if we just select this light, this is going to give me an option of aiming this. So let's aim this light towards the door. And if I want, I can reset the angle and then again the light. So I want the light to be towards the door. And if you see this in isometric view, then you can see this, that the beam or the angle was going towards the door. I am repositioning the light. And then redirectioning it towards there. Now let's just see what is remaining in the house to be lightened. So I think everything is done except for this kitchen portion. So let's just place the lights here. So let's just switch to this luminaries option and So neckline arrangement and this surface mounted light. So I am making a linear arrangement here. And another linear arrangement over the kitchen counter. So I haven't used a light just above the stove, the reason being that its maintenance factor will become high, that I'll have to properly clean the lights very frequently. So I am here adjusting the placement of the lights, the arrangement. I think this should be enough because having a bulb over a fridge is just wastage of light. So let's place this one outside our house. And let's see how it is appearing in the ISO. Just zoom out and okay. The height of the light is quite high, so I'm just going to adjust it. So this is actually a street lamp and I have used this for the outside of my house. This is just for letting you know that we can do this and you can use this light. Otherwise I don't need this light because there is no calculation surface, and I'm not going to there may be a calculation surface, but I'm not going to calculate the lux outside my house because it's of no use. So now I am running the calculations. And on the right side, you can see all the calculations here. One thing that this parking area light should have been away from the wall. Anyways, so this is the lux of my work plane bedroom one. So minimum to average is 0.55 and the minimum to average should be 0.25. So this is fine. This tells me the uniformity of light, and if I'm having 0.25, then this is okay. So I need to have 200 to 300 lux in the bedroom. Let's see if I'm having this or not. So this is average lux is 233. This is fine. Let's see the other one. Here I'm having 222. This is fine, but the minimum to average is not okay because it should have been 0.25, that is 1/4. So if I want, I can change the uniformity of light. Uniformity is just that you will have light at certain places of the room and then there will be black patches, so it is not uniform. Now if I'm using the same bulb, then I can increase the number of bulbs to make the light uniform over the room. But this is not a public place, so I don't think that uniformity is of major concern. So I'm leaving it as it is. Otherwise, I would have changed the uniformity of light and I have made it 0.25. That is 1:4 ratio of average to minimum, or minimum to average. Actually, I can turn on the ISO lines if I want, and I can turn them off as well. And now let's have a look at our house in the ISO view. Let's see how it looks from different angles and in the different rooms. That's how my parking looks. This is my main hall. And if I want, I can see the separate rooms at a time. So say for example, this is how my laundry area looks. These are the ISO lines or the working plane. This is showing the working plane. So I haven't placed anything in my kitchen, so this looks like this. The simplest way to have a look at your house is to zoom out totally. And then come at the level of the house and then
after zooming out, just zoom in.
So that is how your house will look.
And then you can visit your
this is the kitchen area. If I'll go through this door, this will be the kitchen area. This is my main hall. And you can explore further. So from here you can turn on or turn off the ISO lines. ISO lines are the lines where the lux level would be the same. And that is how my washroom looks from the inside, the main washroom. You might have noticed that the working plane is at a certain height. This is by default. And then I have turned to the documentation. This is the most important, because whenever you're doing the lux calculation, you share the report and you do not share this project. You do share this project, but this isn't seen in the normal cases. The report is seen and is of the value. So from here, I am changing the project information, or I am entering the project information. Whoever made this project, whosoever's house is this that you have designed, then you enter the details, because this would be in your report. So from here you can change the project information, and then you come to this tab, and then you come to the edit tab. From the edit tab, you can select what you want to see in your report. So here I am going to check what I need in my report. So say for example, I need this luminary list as well. So I'm going to check mark this. And I think that is it that I want. Now let's switch to this print tab and click this determine page count. Then you'll see that there are 48 pages in my report. And then I'm going to print this. This is how my report looks like. It has got all the technical information that is required. This is the analytical data. So that is it from the Dialux portion, and we are going to design the rest of our house using AutoCAD. So this is all from the Dialux Evo part. Hope you understood it.